Hello, hello, and welcome to CoffeeCraft. I'm your host, Anon Jr., and as you can tell, some things are a little bit different. Over the weekend, I took the opportunity to make a few changes. I did not like the way the enchanting station was blocking all those chests and making it really hard to get at. Same thing with the barrels and workstations here. That seemed like a really good idea in my head, but it was just too cramped. It was way too cramped. It is one of the things that I like to give Arcadius a hard time about, is how cramped some of his builds are. And, you know, I'm tripping over this one block wide path to try to find where the apples are, and it's hiding behind the chest, which is hiding behind the workstation. And, it wasn't working. So all the barrels got picked up, stuff got moved into chests. I still, I am deeply conflicted as to whether I have too many or not enough. Given the way Skyblock works, you tend to not get as much of an overabundance of things as previously. It also helps, that things like the pumpkins stay over in the pumpkin farm, the eggs stay over in the egg farm, the sugarcane stays over in the sugarcane farm. Although I'm tempted to tear those down and build up a bigger one. That might be on today's agenda. So I've got my new enchanting station pushed back. I extended this area out just a little bit more and set up the enchanting station with a little bit more space. That gives me some room over here to do something. I just don't know what. And I got to be careful with that slime chunk there. Now that I got enough traders that sell glass, and since, you know, green dye is not a problem, I am tempted to just buy a bunch of glass and put a green glass floor where the slime chunk is. So that way I know that I need to be exceptionally careful with whatever I build in that space. That whatever goes in that area has to be clear of spawnable surfaces. At least up to Y40. I could always just, you know, not worry about slime chunks by building up a little bit higher. Just, you know, build higher than they spawn. Problem solved. Nah, I've already got too much down here. I do not want to think about rebuilding that 40 blocks up. That's not a lot of work per se, but everything's already there. It's already in place, so that's probably not going to happen. Although, it does mean that I at least don't have to worry about slimes and stuff up there. All I got to worry about is that where the mob farm is, it is some other biome that's not the mushroom biome that everything else is. Everything else asterisk. I changed where this one guy is to ocean, because I've been using this for fishing. Yes, I know. I've been fishing. And my fishing has caught me a frustratingly low amount of what I wanted. I am not the fisher of the server. And so I got plenty of cod, a surprising amount of salmon, some puffer fish. But you know what I need? I need two more of these rotten little tropical fish. Two more. That's it. Just two. At least to get one of the challenges that needs to be completed in order to get the prismarine and to unlock the deep ocean biome so I can start getting some sea lanterns in this place. Then I might redesign a lot of things to include that lighting. I also spent a little bit of time doing some resource gathering, so I stocked up on a little more spruce. I stocked up on... Give me that. I stocked up on a little more dark oak. I started to work on the acacia, and that got frustrating quick. I stocked up on some more jungle, and I started to stock up on oak, and that got frustrating quick. And same for the birch, because unlike a lot of these others, you don't get a nice giant 2x2 tree that gives you most of a stack of wood each time you harvest. So, I might actually do a redstone machine in here somewhere. That it won't be a universal tree farm like I built in season one, but it should be something that'll work with birch. That will work with birch and oak. Hang on, let me take another sip of coffee because I clearly need it. I also took a little bit of time to gather some the warp stems and stuff, and the crimson stems and stuff. I'm eventually going to need to really get cracking on the mushrooms. Of course, now that I got fortune tools and silk touch tools, that should be able to happen a lot easier than it did the last time. Like, I can definitely fortune up some of these red and brown mushrooms and then silk touch the blocks from the oversized ones later. I've also started labeling and locking some of them, not all of them. Working on that part. I've been sorely tempted to just take a day and go through and do nothing but label and lock all of these. But I'm still not entirely convinced how I want to handle some of this stuff. Like, for now, I've been tossing my nether bricks in with the clay bricks, and I probably need to just make a row of move all the nether related stuff from over here to maybe over in that area where I got a little more space now. I wasn't using that storage like I'd intended to because the enchanting station was in the way, but we've already gone over that. I finally got all these guys completely unlocked, so my silk touch guy also gives me luck of the C2 and the order 1. My mending guy also gives me frostwalker, projectile protection, respiration. My unbreaking guy gives me infinity and thorns. Normally I'm a mending, not an infinity kind of guy, but since I hate constantly converting that mob farm back and forth between different types, infinity's become a lot more, I don't know. Although, I don't know if I'll do it today, but I definitely need to get my piglin trading stuff set up too. And I might do that. I'm probably going to end up creating another mob farm very similar to that in the Nether. So that way I can get some a gold farm going. That is going to be interesting. I'll have to think about that one. Yeah, and I got a few other interesting things. This guy. If you remember last week, I hadn't picked up a sharpness guy yet. I hadn't picked up an efficiency guy yet. And after many, many hours of trying, I could never get this guy to get to efficiency 5. So the second time I hit efficiency 4, I said, close enough, did it. And this Yahoo, fully leveled, that's all he gives me is efficiency 4. No other book trades. None. Not one. Not a single one. if it wasn't such a pain to go grab two of these guys and breed up another villager, I might have a new efficiency person. I might still do it just because. I'm also not overly fond of my mason. He doesn't... All he buys is stone and clay. I was really hoping for somebody that would buy one of the fancy stones. But I've already... this is Mason the Second, if you catch my drift. And I'm not sure I want to keep going through masons trying to find one that does what I want. These guys, too. I unlocked the suspicious stews for both of them. This guy is awesome. The first suspicious stew in the list gives you jump. The second one gives you, I think, regen. This guy, however, is a jerk, and he gives you weakness or blindness, depending on which stew you want. Yeah. Oh, hi. Meet the regional district manager for the trade hall. I've also got fetch over here because I forgot that if you let the cats up when you go to sleep, they will occasionally go fetch stuff for you. So there's a cat laying on my chest, and there is a sad black lab staring at me over the edge of my bed, which feels a little too close to real life, but you know. He doesn't always bring you stuff, and he doesn't always come back up to that bed area. I really do need to look into the mechanics a little bit more, how that works. I almost forgot. I took the time, unending trips back to the Iron Farm to trade for emeralds to get the books. That's part of why these guys are unlocked. I finally got myself a nice set of gear. It is not perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but it's about as close as I can get with the books that I have. I set up a gold helmet for my piglin diplomacy, which also has fire protection. I've got my chest plate of protection, so my leggings of protection, and my boots of featherfall-ish, because I can only get featherfalling 3. And that's after a few trips to the enchanting table. You probably noticed that I've also netherrated up a fair amount of the tools. I've gotten all these tools pretty close to what I wanted, except I just could not get looting 3 on the sword, and that's after a couple of trips through the enchanting station. So I went for a plus 0.5 sword of looting adjacent, and yeah, I'll take the looting too. And I've got my Silk Touch and Fortune axes, which are only efficiency 4 because somebody can't give me a book of efficiency 5. No, not cranky about that at all. Same for my picks and my shovels, and I even got some tricked out hoe. So I need enough ancient debris to get those last 3 up to netherite status, and then that'll be squared away. I do always keep one of those handy when I head off into the nether, because I have already gotten knocked off into the lava at least once. Yeah. And no, I have no idea why I stuck a barrel with all my good stuff when I'm the only one that can go on this island. Nobody else can root around in my boxes or anything. I don't need to hide my valuables from, you know, server mates. I also keep hoping that this guy is going to randomly spawn a mushroom, but I'm not sure that I've got that big enough. So I might have to come back and expand this out a little bit more. I can't remember the size platform you need for that. And this is where I was doing my farming for the various materials. This is not the ultimate tree farm. But honestly, after that last resource gathering session, other than the automated farm to get mass tons of birch and oak, I think I might just do this. It's a little more work than a proper tree farm, but it's just me. It's good enough. But I will definitely move all 3 of these platforms closer to where the bone meal is over at the crop farm. Because every time I needed another fistful of bone meal, that was a pain in the butt to go hopping from one side of the island to the other. I might also take this space here and set up another valley like that, but of soul sand, and get a nether wart strip growing over here as well. While I'm here, let's... No, we only got enough for 8. And since I do need a little more dirt. There we go. Nice. I really haven't been harvesting that as much because I don't go through the cocoa beans as much as I had expected to. And honestly, this farm really should be over by the other crop farms. Especially since I could definitely be running that through the composter to get more bone meal. That would actually be a better use of better use of this too. A quick harvest, toss the extra in there. I made one small change to my mob farm. I've got these trapdoors here, So that way I can slay whatever's in here, because I found out the hard way that if you set this to the hell biome and you get nether mobs going up in the farm up there, it works really nice until one of them kind of drifts a little bit when he falls into the water. And since nether mobs don't die by fire damage, they just stand here walking over the fires. So that gives me a way to kill them. I've been using this for XP and gold. I haven't changed the biome back from the hell biome, because this has been a decent XP gold farm. Honestly, just turn that off. Run a lap around over to the tree stations and back, and then I've got a bunch of piglins and even some magma cubes on these platforms ready to go. And then you whack the one piglin and the rest come right to you. and life is good. I've also got a little bridge here, because I got tired of coming out through the portal and finding a herd of zombie pigmen over here. I have no idea why that one slab is there, though. That kind of bothers me. Okay. So I go in and I pull the trapdoors behind me, and then when I come back, I end up pushing most of them into the void. And then I can walk across, punch one, and the rest will run into the void. That's not awkward at all. So this is definitely on my short list of farms to upgrade to get a better melon pumpkin farm going. And to get these guys over there. I might even move this chicken farm here. And probably upgrade it. Although I don't have a butcher, I don't really have, I might just off all the chickens until I actually end up needing eggs, because I got a double chest full of eggs right there. So I don't know, that one's one of those things that I did it because I thought I was going to need it and I haven't. What else is new? I did find out that this does work exactly as planned. I do still need to, I might have actually mentioned that in the last go round too, but once the hopper starts, oh, this is what I changed. I added a second hopper because I found a lot of iron was getting stuck right over here. And so adding one extra hopper, because if you look in Avamance's full design, there's three hoppers back here, and one of them is where that comparator is. So, I couldn't put a third one there if I wanted to and not still have the automatic shutoff. Although, I might still do something with that anyway, because I really don't like this ugly extra bit here. I'll have to find some better way of routing the signal around so I can clear this walkway. But as for later, these guys are doing fine. I added a nice little clock here with a transparent item frame, so I'm not sitting here going, are you guys supposed to be trading yet? Yes. No. Yes? Okay. What else has changed since last week? That was the big part of it. I've mostly been growing wheat in the crop farm, because I needed it for trading, I needed it for target blocks, and that's one of the crops that I can also turn in via challenges for dirt. So I've been going ham on the wheat there, and I still gotta move this micro farm or move the bone meal composter setup. And I'm probably gonna end up just moving the bone meal composter set up and get that set back up the way it was, because that really did work out pretty well. And I'm gonna set up the nether wart farms and the tree farm platform over here in this stretch. I've got I've got to figure out just how big I want to make the melon pumpkin farm to. I might actually do, now that I'm thinking about it, I might do that in strips over here. We'll get to the details on how that works out later, because there's one other update, and this is going to be like high on my priority list for change. Because we're getting back here to where platforms have been extended. I moved my stone cutter over here so that way, because this is where I end up using it more often than not. Although I might find another home for one out here somewhere. This has been working great, except when a block of clay ends up at that very last one, then it's a little less great. But I've been using that fairly well, including getting a couple of ancient debris. This guy is this is kind of the top of my list for today. I need to remodel this. If you remember from last week, I had a comparator coming off of the furnace set so that way when the furnace was empty, it would turn the carpet duplicators off. And here's to unintended consequences. Because I forgot that a comparator pulls a signal based off of the total capacity of the furnace. So when you run out of stuff to cook, doesn't turn it on or off, doesn't produce or not produce a signal. Because if you have fuel in there, it will produce a signal. So you run all your stuff through, and naturally you've got fuel because your fuel source has been running. And so you've got a full stack of fuel, everything's backing up and backing up and backing up, and it's not turning off because as long as there's a stack of fuel down there, it's putting out a signal, keeping the system on naturally. So I've got to figure out a couple of things. I need to compact this down a little bit more. Because this is massive and ugly and massively ugly. I need to figure out how to set up a fueling system that will turn on or off when there is work to be done. And I need to figure out how many furnaces one of these things can fuel. And just how many hoppers I really want to throw into a smelting array. Waiting for this stuff to cook is so slow. I'm tempted to double the to get four furnaces going. Look, if you're ever wondering why Iskal and those guys go with those massively large furnace arrays, this is it. Because you're sitting there waiting for stuff to cook. And the irony is that the last time I was waiting for a big smelting job to cook, I was over here farming more cobble and then turning around, feeding it in there, and wondering why it was taking so long. It doesn't help that I used a lot of my stone to level up the mason, so my stone supplies are a little bit low. My smooth stone supply could be a little bit better. I've been dipping into that, and, you know, 10 blocks here, 12 blocks there, and it all kind of adds up after a while. I'm leaving room for my stairs and walls. Mojang. My smooth stone stairs and walls. Mojang.
What about the concrete?
Yeah, oh yeah, those two. and terracotta. I don't know about the glazed terracotta. Would you want glazed terracotta slabs and stairs and walls?
No.
I could see the glazed terracotta slabs easily. I'm just having a hard time with the stairs and walls, particularly with the textures that they have for the glazed terracotta. Like, if...
I'm having a hard time seeing the slabs. I mean, you're going to have to compress some of those...
Well, I was thinking more of the times when it would be really useful to have a slab that does not get moved by a slime block. Because that's one of the big benefits to glazed terracotta, is that it won't stick to slime blocks when they move. Yeah. So I could definitely see where, you know, once you put a block there, you got to worry about mob proofing it. If you put down a bottom slab, then mob proofing done and you've set up a block.
Okay.
But it would still be nice. It'd almost be nice for stairs and walls anyway. I mean, we got the stairs and slabs for the polished. And I think we got the stairs for the raw fancy stones. But I'd kind of like to see the glazed terracotta move to a texture more like the polished fancy stones. So it takes on a lot of the texture of terracotta, but shiny and smooth. Does that make sense?
It does.
I also realize that I really need to rearrange a lot of this stuff. This is a little too slapdash. Because I got some other stuff there, a little bit of other stuff there. And just to be a contrarian, I didn't want to organize my stuff like Reyes did by color. I instead wanted to put all the glass panes, all the terracotta, all the dyes. I refuse to say out loud that I might have to go back and do it the way that she did it. Not gonna happen. It will not be uttered. Oh yeah, I gotta melt those up too. Alright, let me do this. Let me get this stuff out of here for the moment and pop this on for a little bit. I don't know if you remember, but I mentioned that I was having a little bit of trouble with some of the stuff glitching out and the carpet popping off when it wasn't supposed to. Once I removed all the extra redstone from that was part of the automatic turnoff system, all those problems went away. So I can only assume that it was a flaw in that gave me the trouble I had. I'll get back to why there's cactus there in a little bit. I was just complaining about not having stone and smooth stone, and I just pulled a whole bunch of it out of my hat. I got 2 1/4 stacks of sandstone. Just a bajillion 4 more to go. I will complete that challenge if for no other reason than because it was said to be impossible.
Which one?
The sandstone.
Oh Lord, the Taj Mahal or whatever.
The Great Pyramid.
Yeah.
I got 2 1/4 stacks. Pretty soon I'll be close to the 512 sandstone that I need. Yeah, that Nether Fortress is another one that's going to be a little like, I don't know. that's going to be a tough one.
I didn't decorate with that block. I probably already had enough of it.
Oh, the sandstone?
No, the nether brick.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got to get cracking on that too. I started building a little platform to work with, and I just never quite got it finished. I'll keep building that out for a moment, and I'll let that furnace finish running out. Everything else is done there for now. Oh, I still gotta put this away. And I think I'm gonna start in on the smelter first, because that is one of those things that's kind of holding me back. Like, I really need to cook up more stone. Cook up more smooth stone, and for smelting all the gold from the piglin farm, or the zombified piglin farm. Although I noticed that when you change it to the hell biome, it does end up being the nether waste, so you do end up getting regular piglins spawning in here. But even though the biome is nether wastes, because you're in the overworld, they still end up zombifying, which I find interesting. I kind of expected that if the biome was nether waste, they would stay piglins instead of zombified piglins. But I guess that part of the code checks to see if you're in the nether or the overworld, regardless of what the biome is.
That makes sense.
Which I find rather interesting. Because it does most of the other spawning. Oh, and I finally switched from potatoes to golden carrots. That has been a relief. I also don't know why I made the precious box the top corner one that's so hard to reach. It's one of those things that you go... Now... Why did I choose that? Oh, I don't know.
Questions we just don't ask around here.
I mean, I'm sure it made sense at the time. Oh, hey, you brought me some string. Good kitty. He brought me some potion brewing materials, too. So if I need to, I can make a jump boost potion.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know that I will, but I could. That's something, right?
That's right.
Options. Yeah, I wouldn't mind setting up a couple of potion brewers, but I desperately need to get a supply of blaze rods. Because right now I'm running on the last couple of blaze powder from the rewards from one of the challenges. Well, I guess one of these challenges gives you a blaze rod as a win condition, doesn't it? That gives you a gas tier and a magic bow. And so, wither skull and a blaze rod and a chance of diamonds. Oh. Bricks. The block. Ooh. That's a lot for just one wither skull. And I probably don't want to do any wither boss fighting until I get my end portal. Because I'm totally not doing that on my little island. With my luck, the wither would fall down into the void and I'd lose everything. Alright. What was that?
Only after blowing up half your island.
Yeah, exactly. Alright. Let me put some stuff away. Because it's time to start tearing this completely down and rebuilding it from scratch. Because apparently that's just how I roll. Oh, I need two more furnaces. And 6 more hoppers. So I need 2 more furnaces. If I were me, I would have put the hoppers here. I can't blame Briest for this. Doggone it. Oh, I need 2 more levers too.
Okay, you're just playing hide and seek with yourself.
No.
Yeah, you put the stuff away, and now, you know, you have the fun part of trying to seek it.
Nah. I think I might still blame Rhea since she's not here to yell about it.
Fair enough.
Darn it, Rhea, I can't find anything here. Yeah, let me just tear this whole thing down. I just need to remember that it is... carpet is going to be on top of the piston. Okay. Yeah, I got this. I totally won't tear this down and forget how to build it back. Nope. That would never happen. I would never do that to myself. Is my silk touch, right? Nope, that's my fortune. I should probably switch that over so that way when I do this, I actually get the glass back. Oh, that's a beautiful thing. Oh, silk touch, how I miss you. So what project do you have on the agenda?
Finishing that tower and then, you know, I'm kind of finished. I mean, I may do some landscaping changes once I know what.
I was gonna say, what is this finished of which you speak?
Completed the goal that you set for yourself, and my goal was to make a famous island city. Yeah. I would say I've nearly accomplished that task. Give or take. I just have this eyesore here that I need to finish.
Eyesore? Which eyesore?
The giant tower of, I don't know what it is, behind the church.
No.
Yeah, exactly.
Eh, it's not an eyesore.
It doesn't even have a roof. Come on.
I must be thinking. It's like oh, okay. No, I know which tower you're talking about now. Yeah, okay. No, you got me on that one. I forgot for a minute which tower you're talking about. The one you're making out of prismarine and that kind of stuff, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What other random stuff do I have in here? I probably also won't build inside the floor like this, too. Pick this up. Yeah, there we go. There sure is a lot more than I realized in that. Alright, let me take that with me. Originally surprised at some of that. I'll just take those for the moment, so that gives me a place to put those there. Alright, and I need some stone slabs so I can patch this up. All right. Okay. So what I'm thinking is setting it up so that way there are two furnaces feeding into two double chests each. So there'll be four furnaces, one double chest feeds into those two, one double chest feeds into those two, and they in turn will go into the chests below. I think I shouldn't have started packing that part up. And go one, two, and one, two. And instead of the hoppers coming straight down onto those chests, I'll put them back here like so. That gets the furnaces a little lower, so this monstrosity isn't quite so tall. We'll go, oh. Two, three, four. That's where the fuel's gonna go. So this will be the basic setup for the furnace array. And I wonder if I could line those up like that. Okay, so what I was thinking of doing is taking one of the carpet duplicators and setting it up over here and pushing the carpet into a water stream that runs across these hoppers. The only thing is, with it as close to those, I won't have a way of checking to see if they need fuel. So what I'm thinking of doing is getting a comparator signal from the hoppers in the back, and as long as at least one of these hoppers has no signal, that means that there's no backlog of fuel. That should turn on the carpet duplicator. So as long as there's something in each of these hoppers, it should turn off. So I'm gonna need a couple more blocks behind there. Or I turn that around and make that where I'm working, so that way I got near infinite space in that direction. You know what? That makes more sense. That makes a lot more sense. Well, why should I make sense? Instead, oh dear, I should probably also go grab some ender pearls. I think I'm going to end up in that hole a few times. I think I should go farming some ender pearls because that box is awfully empty. Ooh, that's one of the farms I need to do. I might go make that in the Nether though. That way, when the Endermen go a wandering, it doesn't screw up anybody's island. Because the last time I tried farming ender pearls in the overworld, I ended up getting some Endermen over in Medic's Island and causing some trouble. Because they'd randomly appear in front of them. I can see where that might be a mildly disconcerting issue. What was that?
Slightly.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was counting in my head. Four of these, 4 times 16. I need 5 of those, 4 times 20. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I get that one to be sure. Alright, so we'll have 2 dual arrays. And I'll need signals coming off of the back of there. And then that gives me all that space for the carpet duplicator. And originally, I was thinking of setting up a cactus over here. So that any spare carpet that didn't get picked up by the water stream would end up getting destroyed on the carpet. Because one of the problems I was having with the original setup, his carpet was being duplicated faster than the furnaces could cook them. And when that would happen, the entity count would build up. And I don't want to crash the server due to creating too many entities. I do not want to pull a mumbo jumbo and crash everything because I couldn't keep the entities in check.
What?
Yeah, I know. Crazy, right?
That never happens.
Go back and find that old episode of the circular pumpkin? No, melon. It was his melon farm. It backed up to the point that the melons were a solid sphere. Thank you, Medic. it was backed up to the point that the pile of entities had formed a solid sphere and then crashed everything.
That actually sounds familiar to something I did.
Yeah, well, you know, I wasn't gonna name names, Arcadius, about crashing the server with too many entities.
What? It was only spiders.
And the XP.
I was about to say, yeah. I think it was the XP that did
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it was the XP that did it. It was the XP from killing the spiders.
You know, it was a very good font. That's all I'm saying.
Sure. I mean, in that sense, yeah. I don't think that cactus is going to work the way that I want it to, so I'm tempted to just poke a hole through to the, poke a hole through to the void. Just put a safety cage around it. So, because that was the other thing I was thinking, since I'm so close, like, that I'm a cobblestone slab away from the void. Just setting up the water stream to go right up until here, and then boop, down the hole it goes. Yeah, I might just do that. Although, that also means that my safety cage is going to end up getting into my walkway. I don't like that. Same I am. Well, I mean, I guess I could just do it like that. It would run up to there. I think that's enough space for it to fall down. Yeah, I think if I did that, I'll leave that there for the moment. And then if it looks like everything's going to work out just fine, I'll finish squaring everything away. Before I start doing this, I need to get the comparators down. I also need to grab a little more iron, and so that way I can make some more iron bars. Gee, I hope I have enough. I really do like that automatic turn on, turn off. That has been helpful. And I've needed to hit the manual switch as well a few times. Just because I needed them to stop running around like mindless yahoos long enough for me to trade with them. And I wonder if you guys remember or not, but we actually have the data pack that makes chains climbable.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. No, I know.
Okay. I wasn't sure who remembered or not.
Yeah, no, don't. Okay, I'll go ahead and out myself here.
Okay.
I used to use them to climb out of the graveyard.
Okay.
Until I remembered that the fence of the graveyard is gates.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. You have no idea how many times I ran over there to climb the front entrance gate to get out over the wall.
Mm-hmm.
When the wall is openable.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So about that.
Let me leave the cacti here just in case that does turn out. I need 4 comparators. I do not have 4 comparators. I need to make... I need to make 4 comparators. That is part of why I went and harvested a bunch of nether quartz in my nether mining session. I wanted to make sure that I had enough quartz for this project and the next one. Because I knew I was going to need some comparators for this. And for the melon pumpkin farm I have in mind, I'm going to need a lot of observers and pistons. That's why I got the lumber stockpile. I've been letting the iron farm fill and all that good fun. Alright, I need 3, so I'm going to need 12 torches, right? Yeah. Perfect. more comparators. I'll hang on to those because I'm not sure how much of that I'm going to need. I don't know where the extra 40 stone came from. Kind of bothers me a little bit. All right, so we'll get that out from there. What is... Oh. That's... Wait. I thought you could... Oh, you can't melt down iron bars, can you? There no recipe for iron bars? Nope. There's no recipe to melt iron bars down to nuggets. That feels like a mistake. Because you can melt down armor and swords and all that kind of stuff to get nuggets. But you can't melt down iron doors and bars? That feels like a mistake. That feels very much like a mistake. Aye, Jevo. Alright. So, what I think I need to do is I'll set up the carpet duplicator over here. It'll push it into a water stream that goes here, turns the corner, and then goes this way. I need... I need one more chest? Yes. I need one more chest. And I'm gonna need some water buckets too. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the chest and put that right here. What that's gonna do is so the water is gonna push the item up to the chest and then across. If you look at the hitbox from the bars, stuff will fall through there. So it's going to go up to the edge of the hitbox of the chest, which is going to let it ride that edge of the hopper. If I ran it straight over the hopper, the hitbox for the inside has a little divot in there. And occasionally, what will happen is items will get caught in that little divot. Like, you can even notice it as you walk, where you get that one spot where you're a little bit lower. So occasionally, like, an item will get stuck there. And then because of the way stacking works, the next item of the same type to come through will stack with that stuck item. And you'll end up with stacks of stuck items, which could potentially mean that this hopper fills up, but those hoppers don't. And then you end up never filling these, and so it'll never turn off, and then we get the whole problem again of too many entities. So... I need to make sure that the water comes this way. I mean, I guess I could set up the carpet duplicator right here as well and pump it that way. It's going to block this area off, though. And then how am I going to get that redstone signal from over there?
Pump it.
If I do that. So, no, maybe I'll set it up that here. That way I've got space to route that signal around, which means I need to grab some slabs. I mean, I guess I technically don't need that one right there. Need to put something up on the front side here as well. So the water is going to project it this way. Go here. and then across the edge where it'll get picked up by the hoppers. And if it starts overflowing, the world's best gift bags? I'm afraid to ask what the world's best gift bags are. Especially knowing the individual involved. I love it. Oh no. Oh no, there's more.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. All right. Those are good. Those are good. I'll give you that one. Those are some good gift bags. All right. I need emeralds.
Pretend or I'll burn your house down.
Yeah. Yeah. For some reason, that child. Every time I see that meme photo, that child's face reminds me of someone.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Can't imagine who.
I have no idea. No idea at all. Hey. Get back up. No. No sleeping. Now, get up. I need emeralds. Did I check everybody? I feel like I missed somebody. All right, fine. I'll have to deal with however much glass 36 emeralds gets me. Try again, what? Oh, did you miss the gift bags? Okay. Alright, let me, might as well mend these while I'm at it. I gotta make sure that I tag who sells glass. How do I signal that he has glass, but he doesn't? But he does. And he does. I mean, most of them do. The nice thing about the way the Season 1 trading house worked out is the three guys on the far left didn't have glass and everybody else did. So it was kind of easy to know. But, I don't know. I'll have to remember that. I'll have to think about that. Alright. I need some temporary blocks. Although, yes, I'm sure that's what those people remind me of. I've decided I don't want to do that in smooth slabs. Because I need to throw some stairs at that. Oh, okay, gotcha. I thought you were talking about me. And, like, now It's something other than just you texting me those memes that makes me think of somebody when, I'll just stop right there. Getting smarter by the day. What do I want to use for the furnace array? I mean, I guess I could use diorite. I mean, it's got to be good for something, right?
Supposedly.
Nah, I can't. I just can't bring myself to do it. I probably won't use the smooth andesite, though. No, don't toss them. Okay. We're going to have that going that way, that going that way, at least two more out that way. And I think what I want to do is I actually want to go like a so. Just to have a little bit of trim. For no good reason. So I'm going to have the water go that way. Yeah, so the water's going to go that way. I think what I need to do... That is going to be a problem. No, because if I have the source here... So if I put that slab there... Sorry, a complete thought will emerge in just a moment.
Yep. Just waiting.
Yeah, my brain lost service too. It's okay. I'm told it'll return. Yeah, because if I do it like that, that should be enough to get me around the corner and off the edge. Items. I'll get another water stream going up to this. That'll go around the way. I'm probably gonna end up having to go put that there. The piston's going to be one block higher, so that's going to be too high. So what? So buttons? Who's on first? I'm sure there's another one I'm forgetting. There's a lot of stuff I'm forgetting. Like why I have some of this. And what I need for the next parts. Okay, so that's gonna go that way. That's gonna go one. That's gonna be for one carpet. We'll go two. That should actually be enough. That should actually be more than enough to run four furnaces. Because one carpet was overflowing, feeding a furnace and a half. two should be more than enough. And this is one of those things that I'm hoping that once this starts running low, I can replenish quicker by having more furnace. Just throw more furnaces at the problem, right? Isn't that how that works? When you're not sure what to do, just throw more resources at the problem.
I mean, that's what I do.
Okay, that's probably a sure sign that I'm on the wrong track then. Let me rethink this.
That's a fair bet. That's fair. That server might lag a minute.
Yeah, that's never happened before. Nope, not even a little bit.
No, that was me legit warning you.
Oh, because you're about to do something, or?
I gotta turn the fish farm on, I need more prismarine.
Oh, okay. Uh-oh.
You wanna come see the fish shower?
Oh no.
It's hilarious.
Beach what? Duck, you say tonight, like it's different other nights. Okay.
Ter biome. To deep ocean.
Oh. Worse than normal, huh?
Fishes.
I like the fishes because they're so delicious.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Let the fishes reign.
I'm gonna need one of those guys on there because he's gonna go out and then back. Crikey, that goes a while. Alright. I didn't mean to put a lever there. Did I just lose that lever? No. I thought I had... Okay, nope. I'm losing my ever-loving mind. Those guys are going there. I just need the one lever there. I need a little more terracotta. Yeah. If I were me, I would put the terracotta. there's not a whole lot of design on this one, Beach Duck. This is far, far more functional than anything else I've done. I was getting ready to say, as opposed to all those other designs I've done that were so much more about beauty than function. It could happen. It's going to be a self-fueling furnace array. So, this is going to exploit a bit of a glitch that causes carpets to get duplicated. The carpet is going to get pushed down the water into the furnace to be used as fuel. Okay, so that carpet did make... Okay, so, yeah. And then the idea is once I get a little bit more done... I'm going to hook these up. So once these are empty, It will turn this machine on, and I do need to turn. I need to keep that, yeah, like that, because I need to be able to access that side of the target block. I'll figure that problem out in a minute. Why overcomplicate now when I can do that later?
That's your speciality.
What? Overcomplicating? No. It is just the right amount of complicated. Mojang won't let you in? Oh, are you still having trouble with your Microsoft password and all that? Or is it not letting you into the server because it gave you a new number? And I gotta update the waitlist. I need more information than Mojang still won't let me in. I can't figure out what you're struggling to log into.
I think it's the client. She had to migrate her account. It's been acting so up since then.
That's still actually not helpful. I mean, A for effort, but that's still not actual helpful information.
Oh well. It's an off-stream thing. We shall take care of it.
Yep.
First, I'm going to eat this fish.
Okay. That is actually useful information. Okay. Do I actually need that there? I guess I don't need that there. But I'll just let that sit as it is. Because I like having that wall just like that. For no good reason, I'll go ahead and cover that up. I mean, nothing's actually going to get blown away out of there. But that at least contains the problems. On the launcher, are you picking a Microsoft account to log back in, or are you trying to log back in using your Mojang account? And did you delete your old Mojang account out from the launcher since doing the migration? Wow. You're just gonna laugh at her like that? Wow. I'm sorry. I'm still stuck on Beach Duck giving you a hard time about username password, because I wasn't expecting that. I was not expecting that. Oh yes, the eternal reason for everything, middle child syndrome.
She's moved on from the baby swap idea.
Alright. So far, so good, right? That one's not filling up. That one's not filling up. Where's all the carpet going? Oh, it's getting stuck right there. Okay. I need to get more forward momentum on the carpet before it hits that spot right there. So what if I do that? That means that the carpet being flung should hit here instead of there. Drop down, and that'll give it at least one block worth of acceleration. I mean, honestly, that run up to that corner really should be packed ice. I just haven't had a chance to make an ice tray yet. Where's my carpet going? It's going somewhere. Nope. It's getting stuck right there again. It doesn't have enough forward momentum. I set the drop earlier? Like, do I set it to drop there? That gives it a little more time to accelerate, but it's still not going to get past there. Alright. I think I need to do something about that ice tray. I need ice. Alright. So let me do this then. Let me get a thought. Can I get a thought? Where did the thought go? Let me get a couple of buckets of water. And if I turn go to the island and I go to the biome and I make sure this is down to chunk, and I change this chunk to taiga. I'm trying to remember if water ices over in a taiga at any elevation or only at the upper elevations. I know you gotta have sky access, and this does. Oh, no, there we go. We're starting to get our chunks of ice. Okay, good. So I just need to try to be marginally patient and watch the ice form. Ha, patient. What is this patience of which you speak? Nope. Where'd the other ice go? Okay. I need 9 ice for packed ice. I also don't want to leave this area where I'm standing because otherwise slimes will spawn. So I'm going to need 9. Hey, what's that patient remark supposed to be? I should probably go grab my fishing rod so I can at least do some fishing in the while I'm waiting for the ice to freeze over. What are the odds that there's going to be a slime popping up on one of the ice blocks between when I get a fishing rod and get back?
If you want to fish, you should go get on New World.
No. I'm not getting on New World.
That is a fun.
I'm not saying it isn't. I got too much going on right now already.
I wasn't really trying to recruit you. I was making a fishing comment.
No, I thought you were trying to recruit me.
No, that boat sailed. Mm-hmm. You've been busy. I don't want to mess with you.
Yeah. Everybody in chat, go ahead and vote in the poll whether you believe Arcadius. I should start a poll. Do you believe Arcadius?
Yes, you.
No,
you should.
Yes, I should start a poll, but no, nobody will believe you. I don't even know how to start a poll. I need to do that one of these days when it's going to be a little bit easier for me to not have to focus on the game and the controls and everything else. Can I get a tropical fish? Ooh. No, since this is a taiga, I don't think you can get tropical fish in a taiga. Oop. And I screwed that up. Yep. I've gone fishing. I just need to find a way to retexture golden carrots into corona in a non-infringing way and then sit here and go fishing. Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure that even though it would be free advertising for them, some overzealous idiot's going to try to make a trademark thing about it. Like, hey, I'm giving you free advertising. How do you feel about that? We would like you to cease and desist, please. Like,
if you insist,
I mean, if you insist, I'll go pick a competitor. I'm sure Guinness would be happy.
Just heard some disgruntled noises from somewhere in the house.
What?
About Guinness.
What about Guinness?
I prefer my beer a little less bread.
I mean, look, we could always go back and get that banana bread beer. We just gotta find somebody that does British imports. That stuff was good. I mean, it was like drinking a loaf of bread, but it was good.
Yeah. You know, them talking about in the Bible where, you know, the Egyptians fed their slaves on beer, basically.
Mm-hmm.
I never quite understood how that was filling until I drank, you know, I tasted that banana bread beer and
yeah.
Things like Guinness and stuff, and then it's like, oh.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I could see where this could sustain somebody for a while.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I understand now.
need ice. And I need tropical fish, but I don't think tropical fish will are part of the loot table in Tigas. Although I can't remember if the fishing loot table changes that significantly based on biome or not. Or maybe that's one of those things that got changed with the depth. I hate that I'm that unsure of it, but again, fishing's not my usual preferred game mechanic. I'm not the one on the server who usually does the bulk of the fishing. Like, if we're playing stat poker, number of times a fishing bowl has been cast is certainly going to put me down in the lowest. Okay. With Reyest a close second or lower. Depending. Gee, Arcadius, your voice got higher.
Yeah, it does that.
Mm-hmm.
Has anyone tried the maze yet?
Not yet, but somebody was wondering if he should buy a bunch of suspicious stews of blindness. So whoever went into the maze would have to eat the stew of blindness to, and then make your way through the maze.
Oh, that's hardcore.
Yeah.
You should.
I really like
maze.
That idea.
Come do the maze!
But I've already seen the maze. From the camera account.
And you haven't memorized.
Yes, with my stunningly good memory. I mean, isn't that one of the things that we've learned over a couple of years of CoffeeCraft? Is that my memory is my strongest feature.
Okay, so come do the maze.
I need ice.
I'll farm ice. You come do the maze.
You can't farm ice.
Why?
Unless you go turn your island into a taiga.
Yeah, I can't get onto my island.
I'm pretty sure you don't want to change his island into a taiga.
He says no.
Is 4 packed ice going to be enough?
Whoever did this maze did a really good job. Just saying.
Mm-hmm. Current radius chunk. Change that back to ocean. I don't know why we're all gasping, but it seemed appropriate.
Because I saw a pig in the maze, and it was a bad guy, and it's night, but it's actually Medic Frog with a hat.
Oh, that was so beautiful.
Oh, that's good. That's
good. Go do the maze.
I did the maze already.
Oh, I missed it.
Yes, it was fun.
Ooh, it needs a viewing platform.
Oh, so what? You can watch and you can stand there mockingly going, left. No, your other left. No, not mm-hmm. that left. The left of your left.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. One, two, three, four. Ah.
I declare a thumb war.
No, I needed 2 more.
I love this windmill.
All right, let me at least get that.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see if that'll work anyway. I mean, it could happen, right? Not if I keep doing that. This is getting stuck in that one spot again, isn't it? Oh, no. There it goes. The game's just having trouble keeping up, I guess. It seems to be pushing just a stack around the corner at a time.
Ooh, Arcadius, can your island touch the other island over there?
Which island? The where the CoffeeCraft logo is?
Yeah.
No, none of our islands can touch that one. Alright. That's kind of working.
Can't see me. That's sad.
You know what? I'll see if I can get this to work, and if not, I'll just have to start working on reworking this. So now that that's filled up, this one should be filling up now, so when the next batch rolls through, right, because it keeps dropping carpet into a pile and then moving it forward, which that's the part that I just don't get. I may swap the two glass blocks that are there out for the iron bars. Because that might change the way it interacts. Or maybe I'll put the iron bars closer. Maybe there, so that way the carpet drops faster. Or move this up higher. Alright, so that's starting to fill up. So far so good. Now what I need this to do is I need this so that way when this turns off, this turns on. Alright, I'm gonna need at least... Let's grab some repeaters. I've got some dust. Because I think I'm going to need at least one repeater going there. As long as the signal's one or higher. So let's go like this. And then I should just be able to go. If those... I need to make sure that the signal's strong enough so that way from the last one, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6... Four? Oh, except I need to invert the signal. So torch. So that's going to turn it off. And that'll turn it back on. And let me put a button there. Not because I need to be able to push a button, but so that way nothing spawns on top of it, just in case. Alright. Okay. Oh. Alright. Okay, so I probably need to pull that there, too. Okay. Then I drop that there and that there. The fence keeps me from accidentally falling in, which is probably a very good thing. And any extra carpet that's not getting picked up by the furnace array second. I'm already overflowing, so I've made a logic mistake here somewhere. Alright. I want to turn this on when that is empty. So when this turns off, that turns on, which means I don't need to invert the signal. Okay. No. Because if I do it like the original plan right here. So this is set up. The second all of these turn empty, it turns this back on. But I needed it to turn on as soon as one of these turns empty. So in other words, if I don't do a job that burns all the fuel in all four of these, the duplicator will never turn back on with the current setup. So I need to figure out what to do to set this up so that way, as long as one of these turns off, that will turn back on. I know that what I need is an OR switch. I just don't remember how to do those in Minecraft Redstone, because I need this to turn on when this turns off, or this turns off, or this turns off, or this turns off. Let me keep this off for the moment, because I do want to make sure I get a manual override regardless. Let's pull this up right now for the moment. Why didn't that pull? Weird. Okay. Stuff was falling into the void, even though that last one should have been picking up some carpet. That's mildly disconcerting. Matter of fact, I don't think that actually picked up any carpet. I did from somewhere. That is also mildly disconcerting. All right. Okay. So that's going to be a 15 because that is full. And the second that drops below a certain amount, that's going to drop to a power level 12. It's all based on math, fractional, yada yada, stacks versus how many, etc., etc. But that also means that once we get down to the last stack, that's going to turn to 3. How is that useful? Is that useful? Wait. Oh! I finally got a wandering trader! Hallelujah! Do you know how long I've been waiting for one of those guys? Seriously, dude. Hey. Hey. Come here. Hi, friend. Maybe I can use the coral to grow some coral fans.
You'll be happy with that.
Oh, I'm out of emeralds. I don't want any of the mini blocks.
You'll be happy.
I don't
with
need
that.
Wheat seeds. I don't need ferns. I don't need pumpkins. I could use sand. I could always use sand. And I'm not buying any player heads. All right, let me go deplete my emerald placeholders. Why do I hear a bow and arrow?
Great deals, short time.
All right.
Jelly good.
How are you doing?
Jelly good.
All right, that's everything, right? I got everything out of you that I could.
Some good stuff here. Hey.
Okay. Hi, medic. Thanks for that.
I was trying to help.
Stop hurting my villagers.
Oh, did I really hurt one of your villagers?
No, but you got a couple of arrows that are kind of close. That are a little closer than is comfortable.
I was looking at your screen and I'm like, okay, so he's at the storage boxes. So I'm shooting where I thought the storage boxes were. Mm-hmm. Nope. That's your village.
Well, yeah, because you got one over here by the storage hall, but this guy right here is in the middle of the storage hall. Like, 3-4 more blocks that way, and you've got one of my village people.
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
Nah, we'd have to have some words.
Yeah, from up here, I can see the top of where your villagers are, but I can't see any of your storage.
Yeah, because so it's just outside of render distance.
Yeah, so when I'm sitting right here, I'm like, oh, okay, there's the storage, and that's why I started Nope.
I'm trying to work this out, so that way, if any one of these turns off, it turns off power to that block there. And that's what I'm kind of struggling with. I know that there's a way to do an OR switch, but I don't recall how that works, and I don't know that there's a way to do that with them right next to each other like this. Like I'm pretty sure that I could do something wider where I've got a signal, and then both of those power a redstone output that comes out here. So if this is on, it will continue through, or this is on, it'll continue through, or you throw an inverter over there, or here, either way, whichever works best. But I don't know that there's a way to do that with those guys next to each other.
Hey, I just got booted off the
server. Probably for firing arrows at my villager. No, I
admin privilege abuse.
No, because this character is not admin. My camera account's admin, and I already made the mistake of trying to switch accounts in the middle of a stream. I ain't doing that again. It actually cut off the live stream because it was struggling that hard to switch accounts.
Wow.
Yeah. Before I forget, let me get I might have acquired a few zombified piglin heads. Possibly. And leather. Alright. Something like let me get my those guys in there. I'm done with those guys. I'll find a better home for them later. Thoughts, complete thoughts. I'll have them eventually. Because comparators can read a container through one block. So they either have to be right up against the container they're reading, or there can be a singular block between the comparator and the container, but no more than that. Except for lecterns. You can't get a comparator signal from a lectern through a block, which is weird. How does this help me?
You have to ask that question.
Yeah, I had started a train of thought. And it just derailed. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I'm actually kind of curious because I let that percolate. I need an empty bucket. That only gets me two blocks away. Okay. Because I'm actually wondering if I just move this two blocks closer. Yeah, I might do that. That doesn't solve the signal problem, but that gives me something else to work on while I try to work on that unconsciously, subconsciously. You know what I mean? So let's block off that for the moment. Did you get booted again?
Yep.
Oh, that's mildly disconcerting. No, more than mildly disconcerting.
It says something about not being able to perform something with the host. If it happens again, I'll try to remember exactly what it says.
Yeah.
Screenshot.
Yep.
Or it didn't happen.
Let me plug up my hole to the void until I get this problem solved. Last thing I need is resources drifting down into nowhere. Alright. I'm actually wondering if stuff is getting caught on this corner. No, because even then it's not going to go a full block over and the water should still catch it and move it that way. That never seemed to be the choking point. The choking point seemed to be where it was hitting the water stream and going under. So I should be able to keep that going just like that. And it'll be okay. Don't worry, this isn't just avoiding the problem of trying to figure out how to get the auto on-off function to work the way I want it to. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, as long as I get the manual override to turn it on or off... Actually, no, the manual override will only turn it off. It won't turn it back on. Interesting. I didn't actually consider that. That's worth remembering. All right. So if the water source is here, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 4 more over that way. So that's the 8 that it's going to roll. The server's going to be busy trying to figure out the falling items. I haven't quite figured out why that is. We've been having that problem for a while. It might be an issue with the one of the data packs, but I'm not 100% sure. All right.
Okay.
Okay.
The monolithic tower shrine is done.
Nice.
You're decorated. Ooh. This is going to need to go over one. Yeah. Go. That there. And we'll get our water going that way. That should run all the way down to there. I think that worked. Question mark? I'll just keep shoving extra carpet in there until I can figure out what I'm doing. All right. So that's still going. That's still going to get that going. Because I don't really need an other side to this. All right.
recap. I've got a double chest feeding into two furnaces, feeding into a double chest twice over. I've got a carpet duplicator that should be able to keep all the furnaces running. I got carpet getting stuck in the oddest places. I might have to switch that out for ice. Yeah, I might need two more bits of packed ice. Because I didn't think about that getting stuck there. Although I didn't see exactly where the items were stuck. But I really think it was on top of the note block, which is my usual preferred redstone conductive device, but I forgot that you don't really need redstone per se. You can use pretty much any solid block, he says with the utmost confidence. And if you buy that, yeah, if I remember right, it should be any solid block. What? That storage? I thought you'd already seen that storage. Oh, not challenges. I need biome. Current radius chunk, so I don't do this to the entire island by accident again. No, that's the same storage I had in a while. I just moved some of the other stuff around it. I moved the enchanting station back. I removed a lot of the clutter from in front of the boxes. But that's pretty much been the same size since I first put it together. Alright. I guess while I wait for the ice to form. Does this technically count as ice fishing? I mean, I'm fishing while I'm waiting for the ice to form. Did I just hear a cat? There's a cat over here, isn't there? Alright, I need two more packed ice. Which means I need 9 more regular ice? No. Because I got a little bit of ice already over in storage. I mean, eventually I'm going to want to set up an ice tray and get some mass-produced ice. There we go. Alright, so there's 4 ice. I need... Because this is not the first time. This is not... I needed ice for a few other projects before, and this certainly is not going to be the last time I need ice. Not even a little bit. Yeah, I need to find not a slime chunk to set up a giant ice farm in. I guess my part of my problem... Hi, Arcadius.
I've been here a while. I'm just going to say that.
Yeah. I've been slightly distracted. Alright, maybe more than slightly distracted. Look, I'm just happy you can't go turning all my item frames around. You're trying, aren't you?
No. Hearing arrows ping into stuff around here.
Yeah. I wonder if Medic knows why you keep hearing arrows ping into stuff everywhere around there.
Haven't a clue.
What are you working on, Medic?
just annoying people.
That's your grand project for the day. Causing mischief.
Could be worse.
Alright, I guess I'm not getting to the melon pumpkin farm I was planning on doing today too, because I'm still stuck on the furnace array. That's going to bother me until I figure that out. I will figure that out. Need a way to accelerate ice formation too. Maybe I need to look into an automated ice farm. I've seen those. They work to a varying degree. Basically, you get a flying machine to run around and poke ice down, but it's still only semi-automated because there's no good way to harvest it afterwards. Although I guess if you got a, so you set up the water tray, you get a flying machine to come around, poke the ice blocks down. If you could then move the ice into a block stream like the tree farm, you could probably run that into a TNT chamber and get a fully automated ice farm. I know just enough to consider that might be possible, but not enough to have a clue where to start on that one.
A nice try.
Thanks. I appreciate that.
I figure I could help, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because that's helpful. Yep, that's some quality helpful right there. I don't know what I'd ever do without that kind of help.
That's his middle name, Arcadius Helpful.
Yes, because that's exactly what I hear you yell at him every time he's being helpful.
I can neither confirm or deny these allegations.
Alright. So I'm going to put the packed ice there. That way, stuff shouldn't get stuck on that corner there. So, if this is off, or this is off, or this is off, or this is off, I need to turn this on. Yeah, that. It's the if any one of them is off. Because I could put a comparator here and measure the signal, but as long as that one is on, it will always be 15 here, unless that's the one that's dropping. Okay. Or do I just keep inverting signals? No. Okay. Actually, I probably want to do that back one anyway. So, yeah, that's the challenge. If any one of these turns off, turn off the power there. If any of these turn on, oh, or is that it? That I need to figure out how to flip this around. So the default state for this is to always. Be powered. Actually, the less dust I can have, the better. And then the delay that adds, but redstone dust is actually the laggiest part of redstone. Alright, did you get booted again?
No, that time I got off my own.
Oh, okay. So I want this to as long as that is getting power. That is off. So if any of these turn off, that will flip that redstone torch back on. That just changed the nature of the problem. If that one empties, that will turn off, turning the machine back on. If that one empties, I don't have a good way of turning that off. I need to. Go. I don't remember putting it I don't remember putting it anywhere else. I got that one target block there, and that was it. Now I am losing stuff. No, I put it back. Okay. Let me go make a few more target blocks and note blocks. Because I got the vague notion of some ideas, and I need to make some more torches. I think what I probably need to do is figure out something that works, and then I can worry about compacting it later. Why am I going that way? I need the bales. Oh, I almost forgot. I've been sitting on this expert farmer to turn this in on stream. Oh. Which it won't let me do because my inventory is full. All right, I'll deal with that in a little bit. I'm much too focused on redstone. Just know that I'm going to turn in that expert farmer at some point. I was saving it to do on stream, but let's get some more target blocks, and then I need lumber to make some note blocks. Although I guess target blocks would work no matter what. I put a block there. And a torch. And a block there, and a torch. If this turns off, that will turn on, powering the line. And flipping that switch. Oh, I need one less, one less inversion. Java sighing heavily at me. Okay. So as long as that block is powered, the machine is off, which means with that on, that line is off. When this hopper is empty, that line turns back on. With this line full, that is off, meaning that there's already... All those inverters that I... Alright, so once that is on... As long as that is full, that is powered, turning everything off. How do I flip that? If that turns off. Yeah. this might be one of those imponderables, although it's also 9 o'clock and I've had a full day of work, so I'll blame it on that. That sounds good. Let me just drop everything I'm working on in here. Put the 8 random carpet that I picked up somehow in there. Matter of fact, I can go ahead and bring those back down to blocks. Bring those back down to blocks. Close enough. So I can run around the corner and do this on stream and go, ta-da! Expert farmer done. There's my cow and cocoa beans for some reason. Beautiful. Challenge accomplished. Ooh, I got some levels too. I need to go enchant something. Before I lose all those precious, precious levels, right? Yeah, this might be a later problem. Some. Just not sure how to do enough switches. Or no, I can't. I can figure out the opposite, so that way every time these turn on, I can figure out how to set it up so that way the signal happens whenever at least one of those is turned on. It's doing the inverse. So that way something happens when at least one of these turns off. That's the part that's just boggling my mind. If you got any suggestions, go find the YouTube upload later and leave them. Unless you're watching this on the YouTube upload later, then please, any and all recommendations are welcome. Because I want that machine to turn back on the second one of these, any one of these, turns off. And that's that. And I may have to extend this platform out and build the redstone out a little more, which is why I flopped the machine around. So I've got all that space to build. So if I need to make this platform bigger, I can. Because any measure of signal strength is going to be influenced by the last in line. I can't let it go. All right, where's I need more platform. Let me grab some of those. Don't worry, I'm. It's just until I get that white whale, and then I'll rest. I promise. Do I have enough room in my inventory for all that? No, of course not. Why would I think that I did? Let me toss those in there for now. That's still not everything. I definitely don't need those for now. I definitely don't need those for now. I definitely don't need that. I'm definitely done with those. I still gotta do something about that aspect of it as well, but not right now. Alright. So. Now, because that's still gonna be if that is on or that is on, then it's on. But not if that is off and that is off, it is off. I think I need more comparators. Because I think what I need to do... is... It's going to amplify that, so no matter, so as long as that is on, that will always be a power of 15. If I do that, that's not going to output anything unless it is comparing. So if I do that, that is going to. Okay. Well, that's going to turn on. Going to turn off. Can I figure out how to run four separate signals? No, because I want this to turn off as long as one of them turns off. Okay. This is going to be my weekend project, just trying to figure this puzzle out. I keep thinking that I'm just on the verge of getting it, and I'm not. I'm not even close. So again, I if you got recommendations, video links, article links, something, anything, when one of these turns off, this machine turns back on. Any one of these. I mean, I guess I could group it by furnace, because technically I'm going to fill in that box and it's going to distribute it amongst the two. So it might help to treat those like one furnace and the other two like one furnace. In which case I could do a standard OR gate. So in other words, I pull that one from there and that one from there, and I just ignore the furnace next to it. Because they should be running, if I'm using the boxes and not just trying to run it in one furnace alone. And I guess I don't have to worry about being conservative with the fuel, because it's an infinite supply. So that means that if... if that... so if that turns off, it stays on. Unless they both turn off. Bother. I thought I had it there for a second. I know, that's like the eighth I thought I had that for a second. But, one of these days, it's going to be true. Okay. All right.
Someday.
Someday these two brain cells will accidentally rub together and spark a thought that is absolutely brilliant. Today is apparently not that day, though. I'm probably onto something with treating those two as a unit and those two as a unit, just to get a little bit more space to work with. I guess the problem is making sure that... when that turns off, I get the desired result. And it's got to happen independently of those. Or is that what I need to do? No. All right. Nope. To the credits, to say thank you for joining along. Sorry for the rambly bits. Is anybody still around? Is anybody available to raid? Ooh. Oh. Decisions. Grimly is playing New World and Beast Lord is playing Pillars of Eternity. I'm going to send you guys Beast Lord's way because I like Beast Lord. I like Grimly too. Don't hear what I'm not saying. I just, you know, if it's a toss-up between the two, Grimly's got a very successful following and is doing very nicely. And I want to give Beast Lord as much help as I can. Tuesdays, 6:30 p.m. U.S. Eastern, CoffeeCraft. And normally, Fridays is Games Revisited. The last couple of months have been... Even last Friday, I didn't do anything, because my sleep has been all sorts of ups and downs, and I don't know what to tell you at this particular juncture. So far, all I've been able to promise is Tuesdays. I will do something this Friday. Something. I have no idea what, because a lot of my week is packed. But I will do something this Friday. So I'm going to hit the title card. Let's go raid Beast Lord. Tell him hello. And I'll see you next time.